Hey everyone, today I'm just going to do a beef stroganoff and I'm just going to give you guys a little recipe and show you how I do it. So stay tuned. If you like this video, like, subscribe, share. Awesome. So we're just going to go for the ingredients. Alright, so we just got some beef, diced beef, right? Some beef stock. I use this beef stroganoff, it's really good. A couple capskins, some carrots, potatoes, onion. Alright, simple as that. So, let's get into it, huh? Alright, so we're just gonna get the onions going. I'll tilt you guys a bit more so you can see, yeah? It's frying. Now just slice them, then dice them. Just slice them. Get them browned off. Yeah, it's important to have the right ingredients. No? Could use that in your life too. If you don't have the right ingredients in your life, it's probably gonna turn out a little bit shit, right? So, start off with the right ingredients. Keep it simple. Really? Yep. Just gonna brown these onions off. Find a bit of extra virgin. Get my potatoes cut up. Chucking three potatoes in it. Now it's all going into a slow cooker, so I only really want it in there for 2 hours on high. So I don't want these potatoes too big, just small little cubes. Otherwise they won't cook through, and you don't want to leave it any long because otherwise your meat will overcook. And that won't be good either. Still want a bit of tenderness to your meat. Potatoes chopped up.
What is driving me insane?
Oh yeah, onions is looking good. You want to get them brown, get that flavor going. Yeah. They haven't finished browning off. Right, capskins. One red, one yellow. Just want to stir them down. Cause I dream. And whiskey and you. He's driving me insane. Right, while that's cooking, I don't know if you all can see, let's get down a little bit lower. There we go. What I'm gonna do, we've got the two sachets. Find the countdown. In the bowl. Whiskey.
That's the difference.
Right, beef stock, whole lot. Just 500 ml, half a liter. Oh yeah, getting that flavor going. Come on, people. What the hell do you want it? What the hell? You want McDonald's and Burger King and all that crap to open back up? We don't need that shit in our life. Huh? Keep this all mixed in. Beautiful. Right, I'm gonna transfer this over to the slow cooker. Yo. Look at that heat right up high. Get that pan hot. Some cooking oil in there, not olive oil, cooking oil. Hot, get it hot. Get some beef going now. I'm just gonna do half and half. This is a kilo of beef. Just gonna do half and then half. Get it browned off. Don't worry about the mess. Cooking's messy. Live with it. Good for ya. Alright, so I'm just gonna get all this mince browned off and then I'll come back to you guys and show you the rest. Right, so I just got the last of the meat done. Just gonna chuck that in there now. Just got some quick look in there. Here I got some meat done. So, get the rest in there. Beautifully browned off. Oh. That little toss around. Right, carrots. In. Potatoes. In. Beautiful. Goddamn beautiful. Right. Our liquid. Let's get that in there. A little bit more water. There we go. Right. So now we've got it all in there. All the ingredients. Beef stroganoff. I'll put it up on high. Let's tuck the lid on. And let it do its thing, huh? Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, gee, is that a beer in your hand? And the answer for that question is yes, it is a beer in my hand. But I know what else you're thinking, but thinking, why didn't you put any salt pepper in? Because I'm not gonna put salt and pepper in. Not until it's almost ready. All right? And then if I need to adjust the flavor, I can do it with salt and pepper. No point putting it in now. You don't know what it's gonna taste like. Salt, pepper at the end. All right, I'm not sure if I'm gonna cut this video off here or if I'm gonna come back to you when I'm putting it in a bowl. We'll see what happens. Hey everyone, thought I'd come back and show you a little bit of plating up, eh? So look at this. So look at this stroganoff, and I'll tell you what. God damn, it smells good. Alright, so let's get the plating done. You know, plating up done, huh? You know I could use somebody. Mother like you. Tell somebody like you. You know I could use somebody. Now what you want to do is grab a little bit of fresh parsley. A bit of fresh parsley, huh? Simple as. Let me just try and rest this up here. But you know what, let's just go here. Here we go. So I'm just gonna rip it up. Some on a bread. Some on a bowl. I'm back. Now just grab some good old fashioned extra virgin, huh? A little bit on the bread. A little bit in a bowl. Come on now. Here we go. How about that? Oh my god, I wish you all could smell it. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And there you have it, man. Come on now. If you all like that, give that recipe a go. Nice and simple. Real easy. Yeah, put the salt and pepper last, huh? So you can keep checking the flavor. Because the salt and pepper really does change the flavor of it. So you want to get that right. Now if you like the video, press the like button, that little thumbs up, give it a thumbs up. And then if you look across, it says in a red, it says subscribe. Subscribe. And then it'll come up a little bell. Hit the bell. And then you'll get notifications every time I put up a new video. And if you'd like to suggest something for me to cook, because I can pretty much cook everything, it doesn't matter. If you want to see me cook something so I can show you how to do it, then just write something down the bottom. Alright? And I'll give it a go. Right. Thanks guys. Have a good one, huh?